In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to practice immutability when working with arrays. So here we have an array of three numbers. Let's look at three different scenarios: adding an item to this array, removing an item, and updating an existing item. So for adding, once again, we can use the object spread operator. So I'm going to declare a new constant called added and set it to a new array. Now, first we want to copy all the elements in the numbers array, and then we want to add a new element at the end. This is how we can achieve this. If you want to put this element at the beginning, we can do it like this. Very easy. What if you want to put it at a specific position? Let's say just before 2. Well, first we need to find the index of 2. So index, we set it to numbers, that index of 2. Now, we're going to create a new array. First, we have to copy all the items before 2. To do that, we use numbers, the slice. We give it a start index, that is 0. This is going to return a new array with all the elements, starting from index 0 up to the element at this index, but excluding this element. Now, as I told you, the slice method returns a new array. So we have to spread that array. Otherwise, we'll end up with an array of arrays, okay? So we copy all the items before 2. Now, we add our new item, let's say 4. And then we need to copy all the items starting from 2 all the way to the end of the array. So once again, we're going to use numbers.slice. As the start index, we're going to pass index. Now, because this returns an array, we have to spread that array, okay? Let's do a console.log. So console.log of added. And here's the result, 1, 4, 2, and 3. Now, what about removing? Well, this is very easy. Let's say we want to remove 2. So we use the filter method. Here we pass a function. So n goes to, we want to return all the elements except 2. So n not equal to 2. This returns a new array. Let's store it in this constant called removed and do a console.log. So 2 is gone. Now, what about updating? This is fairly easy as well. So we call the map method on our numbers array. Here we pass a function n goes to. Let's say we want to replace 2 with 20. So if n equals 2, then we're going to return 20. Otherwise, we'll return n. Now, if we had an array of objects, here instead of just returning some number, we would have to copy that object. So we would have to use the spread operator to take a full copy of that object. Okay? So let's store the result in updated and then do a console.log. Take a look. So we replaced 2 with 20. Now, if you forget any of these patterns, don't worry. I'm going to include all the source code that I'm writing throughout this course in a separate project that should be available in the zip file that you downloaded at the beginning. So let me show you what I've done. Here I've created a folder called functional, and all the code that I've written throughout this section is available in this folder. For example, we have examples of currying. We have patterns for updating objects. So you can always come back to the source code if you forget something.